Morning, guys. Lockdown vlog 2. And it's effectively eat what you want day, except for it's going to be of a slight twist. I've been eating like an absolute champ all week with my mini cut, so I'm going to use this as a refeed day. So eat what you want day, I've educated myself a little bit on nutrition and I've decided that I'm not going to eat loads of junk that's processed and full of chemicals and gluten. Instead, I'm going to try and go for a cleaner version of a refeed. And I thought the best way to do that, taking a bit of inspiration from Caleb Noble and Feed the Nobles, is to prepare the food yourself. If you can be asked to look after your health and nutrition and well-being, you can be asked to prepare the food yourself. So I'm going to change Eat What You Want Day for today to Bake What You Want Day. And I'm going to be making some unbelievable treats that have got good ingredients in them. It's 10:28 now. I'm doing an Instagram Live. Hi, guys. Friday the 1st of April. 11 o'clock, pretty summertime. I'm going to be doing a live Q&A whilst I'm on the rower. So if you want to join me for that, that'd be awesome. Hoping for more than one person viewing, and that's my mum. Hope for some good questions. So enjoy the vlog, guys. The most ideal weather for an Instagram Live. Fantastic. About 10 minutes before I go live, making a makeshift iPhone stand because I don't own one. So this should be quite interesting. Hopefully it holds up. Feeling quite apprehensive, not because I'm scared of the questions, but I'm worried that no one's even gonna watch it. So, just gotta hope for the best. Hope some people not only watch it, but actually ask some questions. Good news is, the sun is starting to peek through the clouds, so it might not be a washout. That looks alright, look at that. Sellotape plus rubbish old stand equals Instagram Live iPhone stand. Decent. Everything's set up, the stage is set. Ah! Oh, okay, bring on the one viewer and the zero comments and the zero questions. Let's do this, come on. Schmidt, have a good workout, mate. Catch you later. Any more questions? Ashley, why don't you pose a question to the whole of the chat? Come on, you got something in your locker. Let's get a discussion going for the last round. Okay, so creatine monohydrate is one of the only supplements I'm using at the moment. So I'm using creatine for performance enhancement as well as caffeine. So that's the reason why I use creatine. That is my subjective opinion on creatine. From personal experience, so I wouldn't quote me. Like I said, I'm not a doctor, I'm not an expert. The only thing I am an expert in is Gareth's gyms. There's a lot of trial and error in this gym. From dip bars falling down, to row machines that don't work. The penultimate round. Okay, final round. Why not, eh? And the idea with these, you're putting in manageable repeatable sets, so things like ring push-ups and a hang. I'm comfortable doing 15 seconds and 7. If I wasn't, if I was struggling getting a 6th, 7th, I'd drop it down to 3 or 4. It's about doing things that are achievable without overstressing you and overtaxing your body. That's it. The first ever Instagram Live I've ever done is complete, and it actually went quite well. There's some brilliant discussions going on there. I'm buzzing off of that, better than I ever could have imagined. I think it's time for meal number one. What shall I bake? as you're aware, it is Bake What You Want Day, but I'm going to make a conscious decision. I've not tracked macros today. I've been tracking them all week, and I've been doing a good job of that. So I'm going to get rid of the macro tracking today, but I'm also going to make a conscious decision of not eating any processed food. So everything that I eat today is going to be made by yours truly and my wife. So wish me luck. First item of the day made, that is the Pop-Tart porridge, I guess. Cookies in the oven at the moment, the protein cookies are currently baking. Peanut butter cups are in the freezer for their first little blitz. Decent little recipe. Bring on the cookies.
The cookies end up being a disaster. Come out light and fluffy, spongy, not a cookie. So bake them a little bit longer, just end up getting browner. Feed the Nobles, help me make a cookie, please, because this is a disaster. It's all right, got a backup plan. Plan B. Heart and my heart will go
on and on. Beautiful. There's one thing that wasn't a disaster, and that's the peanut butter cups. Just take a moment to appreciate that. Look at that. Baking may not be my forte, but prepping and freezing is. Damn. The secret is in the fact that it's dark chocolate, 85%. It's nowhere near as sweet. And the peanut butter mixed with coconut oil, when carb fails, you've got to turn to fat. This is pretty much 100% healthy fats. So good, in fact, one won't do. Oh, anyone want a tire? Hers, his, yeah, I think I need another one in my life.
While I'm eating my, we baked something. Sorry, what are you
Pretty much the day has been spent preparing food, eating food, and sitting in the sun. So that's one down. Bring on the next. Might have to make a new batch. Right, look at that. Oh, damn. Damn. Look at that. Jesus Christ. Is this pornographic? Oh my God, look at that. Put these in packaging with Uncle Moss all over on it. And there's my £1 million idea. Two down. He's going for the hat trick. They're in the freezer. How were yours?
Beautiful.
Magnificent, look at this specimen.
Mine's nicer.
Oh, what's in yours?
Jam. And nuts.
What nuts?
Pistachio. Architecture.
Should we package them up and sell them?
No, I eat them.
They're quite a chocolate. Covered. You hate peanut butter? I'm sorry. And dark chocolate. I'm sorry for the last however long. For the worship of peanut butter cups, but it's just unbelievable.
Okay, I think I'm gonna go for the second workout of the day.
feeling a little bit bored. I feel like I've got loads of energy from all that food. So, to kill some time before dinner, which is going to be a curry, decided, homemade curry, I'm going to go for a little bit of resistance training. I'm going to show you my ritual. This is my pre-workout today, so I've got this left over. I've got some super strength green tea for a bit of caffeine. I only ever have one coffee before workout, one coffee a day before a workout, and I've used that up already, so I'm going to go for this. And I had some arginine left over, so I'm going to go for some arginine and green tea. The arginine tastes disgusting. It tastes like fish water, that's what it tastes like. So I'll open up the computer, I'll see what the workout is for the day. I'll write out on my little workout log whilst the caffeine's kind of processing in my body. And then this is my reference. I'm still looking at my phone because I find that phones, you look at your workout, then you'll be distracted by something else. So this keeps it simple and keeps the attention on the workout. So let's get right in. So as I mentioned earlier, I am going through my program and I'm in the final week now. Today is going to be a pull, squat, mobilization session. So I've got a few things in there. I've got negative pull-ups, banded lat mobilizations, reverse planks. So it should be quite a good little session. I don't often do two workouts a day. But like I said, I've got an excess of energy that I want to burn. I want to kill some time as well because I'm a bit bored. And this morning's workout wasn't resistance training, it was more of a sustained aerobic focus, whilst this is going to be more targeting muscle groups, time under tension and things like that. So it's working in different energy systems, more working the anaerobic energy system. So let's do this. Sweet, so training done for the day. That was actually my first fed workout of 2020. Very fed workout. Time to get the food on the go. It's gonna be a chickpea curry. First actual refeed meal of the day. The rest were just child's play compared to this. This is a chickpea curry. So nutritious, so full of carbohydrates. Let's get into it. Today the missus is very happy because I managed to shift the farmer's tyre. People are building home gyms, that's what it is. Uncle Muscle tyre. So that's it, whole day of eating, successful refeed done. Not much successful baking though, because pretty much the only baking that was done with the cookies and ended up horrendous. I'm going to make it my mission to do a few successful bakes over the next few days. I've got some recipes in mind, so I'm going to have a go at that. Just to quickly touch refeeds, it's not a binge, it's not eating whatever you want. I try to take a different approach to it, making sure that the calories that were consumed were dense in nutrients and served a purpose. This refeed can definitely be beneficial for my mini cut. I'm taking 6 weeks to try and get rid of a little bit of body fat. Structuring a day like this can help me push my calories back up to maintenance, to cycle calories, prevent hormonal downregulation, and hopefully accelerate my progress. A lot of people will bang on about glycogen replenishment. However, when it comes to refeeds, 24 hours might not be long enough to fully replace your glycogen lost. I'll use this refeed more as a psychological adherence to the protocol. As I'm only doing a 6-week mini cut, and it's quite an aggressive 6 weeks, so to ensure that I don't fall off the bandwagon along the way, this one day a week will help me to address cravings. So as long as you address cravings and don't ignore them, you're not gonna over binge. So that's it. I'll put the whole day of eating in the description. I know I said I'm gonna track, but I'll try and track those close as I can. If you want to try out my free sample, make sure you click the link and subscribe to UK Fitness Equipment's mailing list. And until next time, guys, enjoy.